Hello and welcome. You may have seen this on AliExpress before. This has been out for a while. This is a mini PC M.2 network storage device. It supports four M.2 drives, while being small enough to be able to go into your pocket, just barely though. With a back-to-school coupon, I was able to purchase this at $187. The price itself is a big bargain, because it's what I'd say for a regular mini PC with similar spec. Given the fact that I don't pay taxes for AliExpress purchases, it's a bargain for sure. The reason I chose this over others is that this is the only one that provides some sort of cooling for M.2 drives. The top bit acts as a giant heatsink for the drives. Others of similar kinds provide no cooling other than some holes for air circulation. That may be fine for just one drive. But when you plan to use four drives eventually, I felt that cooling should become a necessity. It arrived like this in a box, decently packed in other words. I see a warranty card, but I am going to discard that. Sending back and forth to China, the shipping will eat a good chunk of your changes. I also see that they provide thermal pads. Not bad at all. The power brick is rated for 60 watts. Which should be more than enough for a device with N150 CPU. Right, I forgot to mention that. It's got a N150 CPU, which is just a tad better than N100. They do have an option of choosing N305 or N355, but the price gap was just too much for me. It had cost over $100 more. No, thank you. Besides, N100 is more than enough for a network storage device. I know this from my own experience. It has only two USB ports, which you may find not enough. But remember that this device is meant to be a network storage device. For such a device, two is more than enough. I am going to be using only one port for unraid USB stick. Everything will be managed via a web interface. The top bit is held by four small balls. It requires a bit of force to open it. The four holes on the top bit is for you to install a fan, should you feel the need. We even place a heat sink on a single M.2 drive. Using four of them and not having some method of cooling seems not wise to me, which is why I chose this one over others. It's not tightly fit. But I am assuming here that, once you install drives and thermal pads, it will firmly fit. The M.2 interface is NVMe and PCI Express 1X. It's my understanding that they are using a splitter from a PCI Express 4X, since N150 CPU has very little available lanes. It may sound gimped and, well, it is. But even a PCI Express version 3.1 lane is 1 gigabyte per second. Given how slow mechanical hard drive is, this is a huge upgrade. With overhead and all, I am assuming here that I am going to get around 850 megabytes per second. That's a huge upgrade from 150 megabytes per second from hard drives. Since I purchased this barebone, I need to install RAM, so here we are. They are indeed using a M.2 splitter. It looks custom made just for this device. The case is aluminum, by the way. The whole thing is metal, and it is quite heavy. The more I look at this, the more I feel that the price I paid for is indeed a bargain. This looks like a quality machine. I am going to start with two 4TB NVMe drives. I am unable to afford four all at once. For the purpose of network storage device, speed doesn't matter. TBW or cell endurance is the only thing that matters. The top one has TBW of 2400 and the bottom one has TBW of 3000. Anything over 2000 is fine for my needs. Some of QLC 4TB drives have low terabytes written of only 900. Absolutely avoid those. Yep, now it's a tight fit and doesn't rattle around. It's time to boot into BIOS. Just so you are aware, it booted using my unraid USB stick without any modifications in the BIOS the first time. If you are planning to use Unraid, you don't need to enter BIOS, is what I am saying. Overall, it's the regular shebang. I enabled C states and fiddled around the boot order. Other than that, there was nothing really to alter. The BIOS also confirms presence of two 2.5G network interfaces. Given the fact that it is capable of around 850 megabytes per second, a 10 gigabit network port should have been more ideal. Everything looks good to me. I was actually somewhat worried of RAM compatibility, but it looks like everything is working as it should. I think it's time for closing words. I think this is going to be the first time where I fully recommend an AliExpress product. Yes, this pocket device has my seal of approval. The build quality is excellent with all metal case. Its price is unbeatable as well. And I forgot to mention this, but the CPU cooler is full copper as well. It's really hard to pinpoint any faults on this. You may frown at the drives being bottlenecked by a mere single PCI Express version 3 lane, but you need to keep in your mind that this device is bottlenecked by the network port speed. With a pair of 2.5G network ports, the most you are going to get out of this is around 420 megabytes per second. Only a 10 gigabit network port is capable of saturating a single PCI Express version 3 lane. In other words, it's perfectly fine for them to use a splitter to split the lanes. Having said that, the only flaw I see in this device is the pair of 2.5G network ports. It should have really been a single 10 gigabit port. Still, I am hardly disappointed in that. Overall, this is an amazing device for its price point. Finally, this device consumes 14 watts on idle. This is something you can run 24/7 and not worry about your power bill too much. Thank you for watching and see you next time.